Okay. Paper Mario.
Yes.
Are we online? We're online.
We're online. Our internet hasn't crashed yet.
No, I didn't plug the LAN in.
And our microphone hasn't broken yet. I expect one of these things will change, because they tend to.
Well, that's what we're on the screen for. We got...
The water is clean again. Now we're going back to... back to Rogueport.
We're going on a vacation.
Because we've had a hard chapter. Let's have an easy chapter. A Paper Mario.
Piracy.
Gonna relax in Rogueport.
Did you set the delay?
Yeah.
Good.
We're gonna relax with our riches obtained from piracy.
Them Italian pirates.
We never have to work again.
So I've actually... I mentioned at the end of the last stream that I was going to be doing a little bit of grinding.
Yeah.
And I did so. And now we have... a bunch of the badges we need for Danger Mario.
That is still way too loud.
Yeah, it's still pretty loud. Try 40, maybe?
40. Okay. Well, that was going down.
I know. It's gonna sound louder to us than it sounds in the final video.
Fair enough. I'm gonna have to adjust.
Okay.
So, you're gonna start playing a very risky play style.
Yeah, you say that.
Well, whoa, go back.
Oh yeah,
I forgot he has like a flower dude with him.
Luigi's got a Daisy.
Daisy.
Who's a director, and he wants Luigi to be in his plays.
I get it, because he looks like a light.
As grass.
Watch him grow.
I'm waiting for there's actually
a light. So somebody's going to see this play, and they're going to make, like, a review that says, this is like watching grass grow.
Well, that means Luigi was the center of attention. Good job, Luigi. Okay, so we got...
Luigi's richer than all of us. He owns a mansion.
Yeah. He actually is going on his own adventure this game that we didn't really talk to him about.
We're not talking to him about it because it's none of our business.
Once we start, he won't shut up about it.
Yeah.
Hello. What impeccable timing. Yes, this was destined.
Destined.
When I consulted my star charts, I saw a portentous sign for you, Mario.
Oh no, grim portents.
In the house of the dragon that flew through the air, beyond the reversible stair. Near the empty black chest that cursed you lies a clue to help your allies learn. I have no idea what it means. Seems like pretty straightforward directions to me.
Seems like we gotta do a bit of backtracking.
Yeah, so I actually forgot. First things first, we have Bobbery now. We have Bobbery in boats, so we can actually do a bunch of stuff. We might
not even get to the chapter.
We might not do it, the chapter itself, because we got a lot of other stuff to do. Side quest rumble. And we can get finalize our party this stream. We can get our last party member. Bobbery's total last party
member. ending it with Bobbery. I mean, he is pretty useful. With his ability to explode anywhere at any time.
Hello, friend.
Hello.
This is Chet Ripo. And this is Chet Ripo's Adjustment House.
Is it because he's a rip-off artist? That's why they gave him the name? It's not a rip-off artist because he's
actually
good.
In the previous game, it was a rip-off because you didn't know what you were getting into. But this one, you actually do.
He actually is like, okay, I'm going to level with you.
I'm
not actually going to make you stronger. I'm just going to rearrange. I'm just going to respec your skill points.
Yeah. In the previous game, he said, hey, I'll increase one of your stats by like 10 and it'll be great. And then you do it and both your other stats are lowered.
Oh, both?
Just without telling you.
So, that's actually a net loss then.
No. Get two levels in one stat and both your other stats lose one level.
Oh, okay. So, this guy is the same species as all the other, like, mage people in this universe.
It's probably the most dramatic change between games, because last game he was like a duck wizard thing.
Well, maybe the title's inherited. Maybe this guy proved to be the superior,
Ripo?
Respec mage.
Yeah.
I'm a respecer. I can't buff you.
There's gotta be.
I can take your other stats to make you powerful in one certain way.
There's gotta be a name for that. Respecer, right?
Min-maxer.
Like a mage.
Yeah, just a mage that has the ability to min-max whoever you are.
Let's see what Dazzle has. Oh, something else we can do. Let's just make this a lot easier.
Yeah.
There we go.
Yeah, nobody's gonna miss that ancient pillar.
Nah. Archaeology, fuck that. Flower saver.
Jackie Chan who?
Quick change probably be good to have.
I'd say that'd be like a really important one, because if you don't have that, then you're fucked.
Flower saver.
If you don't have that, you need to change out. 7 BP. Then
they increased it from 4 BP to 7 BP this game.
7.
Yeah.
They realize it's really useful. I mean, can you blame them?
Yeah. I actually looked up I was looking up where to get the badges for Danger Mario,
yeah.
Because there's one of them that can be, first of all, badges stack in this game. You can get multiple copies of pretty much every badge.
As they should.
Yeah.
Like, I love it. You just, rather than like, I expect all these other badges, you just have like 50 of one badge and you just hit for like 500 damage or whatever.
Yeah, it creates more build variety. Whereas in the previous game, there were a finite number of badges. You could only get so many of each.
It's the difference between, I guess, like, playing 50 of one card in a card game and, like 4 copies of, like, a few cards.
Yeah.
I'd much rather have the latter. Simply because you can focus on just one specific strategy rather than just...
So you can stack badges, and one of the important badges for Danger Mario can be got here at the Pianta Parlor, the gambling place.
Yes.
And I'm actually going to do...
What is it with Japanese games and their obsession with gambling shit?
I got 364 Piantas. So I don't think I actually bought the badges. I just ground the stuff for them. I'm going to do one playing game just so people can see what I was grinding.
The easiest game to grind.
The most profitable.
When
best
we were
way
playing this
Piantas.
Back in Jobcore, I'm like, yeah, why bother playing the other ones? This is the only one you need.
This is the only one you get a significant amount from.
Yeah. The only one you need. The other two are useless. So, I was going to mention this. Japan's got a weird obsession with gambling now.
In games, yeah, there's always a gambling parlor in Japanese RPGs.
Well, not just in Japanese RPGs, but in Japan in general.
Yeah. Well, like, you know, there's pachinko. You can buy your groceries.
Well, that's another...
And that's how you profit, ladies and gentlemen.
Times 3.
I actually got really lucky. It's rare that that lines up so perfectly.
45.
So you get a 35 Pianta profit on a good run. And that you just do that forever if you want Piantas.
But it costs 10.
The other fastest way to get Piantas is to grind coins, fill them up, and then just buy them. So same as the Pokemon gambling parlor.
You don't have to gamble if you don't want to. We can make it so that it's optional.
But once you get
the Piantas, it doesn't transfer back out into coins.
No. Well, actually, you can once you have all of... What I forgot to account for is that you only start with, like, 5 of these prizes available, and you have to get the cards to actually play the games from the Trouble Center requests.
Oh, so, yeah, those that do have a point.
And you also get, when you unlock a game, you get, like, 3 more prizes available. So I forgot that you actually couldn't do any of the games by default, and I had to do a couple of the Trouble Center requests. But that's okay, they're boring ones. One of them took us to Hooktail Castle, where we're going to be going anyway, so that would just have been a double trip.
Yeah, we don't need to see that shit.
And one of them was in the Pit of 100 Trials, which we'll
no,
do later.
Okay,
that's how you
change. Yeah. I stand corrected, you can cash them out.
You can invest in gold, ladies and gentlemen.
Gold, yeah.
This is also great because you can get extra HP and FP, as many as you want.
Mm.
Which is, you know, for...
Heal as much as you want, but...
Badge point
that's
going
to be useless for this kind of run. Well, maybe FP plus would be nice.
So I actually don't have the badge that I need available yet. I got to get the next card, which I don't think we can do until after this chapter. So we'll be playing a limited Danger Mario for the time being.
Difficulty Danger Mario. So, that's the thing about Japan is that in the very beginning, they were like all obsessed with arcades, like, you know, arcade fighters and stuff.
Yeah.
And just that was really good.
Yeah, they were really popular in Yu Yu Hakusho.
Then it evolved into crane games. That was a big thing in Japan, that arcade scene.
Yeah.
And then it's pachinko. So much so that Konami is getting in on that market. I'm like thinking, and somebody is like thinking, are the Japanese, like, companies training Japanese citizens to become gambling addicts?
I think pachinko was before the other stuff. Yeah, but I know what you mean. Because
that was Maizonokoku.
Okay. Urusei Yatsura was Discotex. They didn't have arcades yet. Maizonokoku was pachinko. Ramen One Half was... They didn't really have anything. And then in, like, the later... In Yu Yu Hakusho, we had arcades.
Is there ever a scene where Inuyasha is just at an arcade, just like, how do I make these sticks work?
No, but I wish there was.
He puts his fist through a window. That would have been great to see. That would have been something.
He just punches into a crane machine.
Grabs a toy and just gives it to Kagome. Just like, here you go. Yeah, Inuyasha! Well, you don't need to destroy that. Now we can't go back. He's like, those damn devil machines.
Okay, make something good happen. Happy Heart.
Happy Heart is necessary? No.
No, I'm looking around at what exactly I want to have equipped.
Do you need ice power for this next one? For the train?
Not for the train, I don't think.
Midnight train?
Quake Hammer would be good. I'd like to clear one more thing up for... I don't need Power Smash. For more FP. That'll be good for now.
Alright, so no quick change then. Wait, can you stop?
What? Oh, yeah,
because his health is at 5. He's always in fucked mode. So it's basically just...
So the point is I lower my health to 5 at all times and equip a bunch of badges that only work when you're at 5 or less health. And the 3 badges that do that are Power Rush, which gives you 2 extra attack power per hit.
It's like you see an old man just walking down. He's got, like, a bum leg, and he's got obvious back problems, and his sight's not doing so well, and you try to kick his ass, and he just fucking floors you and schools you, and it's like, what the fuck just happened? That's Danger Mario.
Power Rush, Last Stand, which drops your damage taken by half when you're in danger. And Close Call, which makes enemies often miss when you're in danger.
Yeah, that's exactly what I mean. The old man floors you.
Yeah. I know, I was still listing the badges.
Sorry.
Okay, so we got the boat 2 now. Again, we got a lot of accessibility stuff. I might just do some...
At this point, the entire world should be open to you, right?
Pretty much. We don't get any new partners, and I think we have all the curse abilities, so we should be able to pretty much go anywhere.
Yeah, world's your oyster.
Here. Nothing.
Of course, Skyrim would allow you to do all this immediately.
But then where's the sense of progression?
It happens when like, stuff changes in the world.
Double dip.
Oh, that item we never use.
Yeah.
Because we don't use items, like...
I was looking up the...
It's an item that's good in theory, but doesn't, like, isn't conducted to any real strategies, like... A lot of junk rares in Magic the Gathering.
I was looking up the, like, a badge guide for how to get the badges for Danger Mario. Some of them drop off enemies. And, he had it was a full list of different badge strategies that you can do.
They're full of badge strategies, yes.
And, one of them actually did center around having a bunch of, like, double dip, triple dip equipped and just using items.
Huh.
There was one that was all about getting, like, the maximum star power and just using star moves.
Oh.
There's one with, like, making your partner the superpower and you could just hide behind them. Oh, I think the most creative one I saw, which you can't do until after you've done everything in the game, basically, because of the badges it requires, but... There is a, the badge you get for completing the Pit of 100 Trials is called Return Postage, and any enemies that hit you directly take half the damage they deal back.
Yeah, that sounds like a badge that should be stuck in the bottom of a pit, never to be uncovered.
So you
it's too powerful.
So you can have that and just fill yourself up on hit points and not defense and watch the enemies kill themselves.
The Orihime strat.
And if you, there apparently there's an item in the game that does the same thing. So if you stack them, then enemies deal their own damage back.
The Orihime strat, where she just puts up a shield. You attack it, you get hit, and she's like, oh, what's the matter?
That's the Kenpachi strat. But I cut him, why am I bleeding?
Kenpachi did it first. Kenpachi did it so well that Orihime decided to make that part of her main offense.
HP drain. It's okay.
Yeah, I mean, she figured out how to, like, combine her powers so that she was able to do that shit. It was great.
Yeah? I take it that's in the Vondenreich?
It's either in the Vondenreich arc, or it was in, like, the very beginning of the Fullbringer arc.
I don't remember her being really involved in the Fullbringer arc at all.
Yeah.
Sadly.
Nobody was very really involved in the Fullbringer arc.
It was a very short, very strange arc.
It was very strange is right. It was like the very beginning of the Chapter Black saga in Yu Yu Hakusho, where it was like everything was kind of sketchy and you didn't know who was on whose side.
Yeah. Oh, I don't have the Ultra Boots yet. That's one mobility thing.
Yeah.
So we'll get those in this next chapter, but for now, let's do some Trouble Center stuff.
Go ahead.
Oh, we gotta get the party member.
Yeah, you keep forgetting that.
Da, 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 da.
Oh, yeah. I'm after an elusive badge.
Must explain in person. Meet me on the roof of Zesty's house.
What badge is this?
What is it people with doing on being on roofs all the time? Like, that had to have pissed people off in the desert town in the previous game. And now Rogueport, everyone's jumping around the roofs.
Yeah.
Well, I guess not everyone. We're the only assholes
doing
that. Well,
okay, to be fair, it's Mario. Mario has a tendency to just climb on stuff and jump from place to place, so it's a given.
Yeah, just Goomba family is here and, like, shuffling on the roof. What's that, Daddy?
Well, the closest distance between two points is a straight line, and rather than go around buildings, you know, just go over them and it's quicker.
That's just Mario, son.
Yeah. I mean, yay.
Hello. A strapping fellow like you. All right.
This music is very,
this badge is hidden in Hooktail's lair. And that's why we're doing this at the same time.
She's basically Rouge.
Pretty much. Except a much flirtier Rouge.
Yeah, Rouge.
Rouge flirts with her female partner a lot, not with guys.
Does she flirt with anybody in Sonic Adventure 2? She's like...
Very mildly.
Her and Knuckles were kind of getting it on a little bit. Like
very mildly, but not... Okay. Not significantly. Off to Hooktail. I guess there was never a Goomba down there.
No. What Goomba? What are you talking about? There's the Goomba.
Oh, there's something up there that we also can't get till the boots, though.
Yeah.
Oh, hello.
So this room is apparently really important for, like, a skip. Because I think you have to jump in a certain way that you take damage, but the game registers it at taking damage in, like, absolute middle point, so you can skip a certain section by not...
Absolute middle point? What?
Yeah, like, you take damage, but the game, like, doesn't register it as you having come from here, but having come from the area where the pipe is. Nice one.
Oh, okay. I forget what's in that pipe. It's just an empty
You're
house.
You're down
I
to
think.
3 HP.
Oh, right. Yeah, I can. I
you,
forgot.
You have to.
I
have
forgot
to,
there's map damage.
Yeah, you have to be careful here. You're down to 3 lives.
Nah, we're fine. I'll just. The only healing item I need is mushrooms. I'm saving money. I just switched to Geico.
At least, well, to be fair, a mushroom is more useful in this state than the.
Well, exactly. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah. Hell, a life shroom would be handy because you could just, no matter what, it'll heal you to hit full.
Waddle, waddle, waddle. Good save.
Yeah, you saved it. Man, this castle just... This castle feels lifeless. It's just like, there was somebody here, they're gone now.
Yeah, I mean, felt comparatively pretty lifeless before.
Yeah, all the dead bones when Naysir came in and just killed everybody.
Yeah, that's what Naysir does, he kills skeletons.
He raids castles, kills monsters, and then moves on to the next one.
Which is always immediately north of the previous one.
We're good, man. What pisses me off about Lagoon isn't even, like, really the combat system, because that was just a botched port.
Yeah.
What really pisses me off is just the lazy map design. Like, everything looked the same.
Yeah, there were no landmarks or anything.
And everything was in the same room. It was like, rather than just having a bunch of little small rooms so you can kind of sort of get your bearings, it just had it as one big room.
A big maze.
For no reason. So glad I'm done with that game. So not here, but somewhere else.
No, this is where Merlin was talking about.
Yeah, you're right.
So there was the... Trouble that you have to complete to get the plane game was also one that brought you to Hooktail's castle.
And also you need to be here because a wizard told you to do so.
Well, that's what I'm saying. If I were to have waited to do that trouble, then we would have had to come here, go back, and then come back for Ms. Mouse.
Yeah. Oh, you got an up arrow.
Because you can't do two troubles at the same time.
Yeah. Hey, you got an up arrow.
Yeah, that'll fit right in with my letter P.
P up.
Does that give me, like, the permanent flight from Mario 3? That'd be cool.
Penguin. Mario's just flying all over the place. Like, that Goomba doesn't know what the fuck.
Can you imagine flight in a Paper Mario game? Just like...
That's the fucking paper airplane.
Well, I mean, like...
I guess that's technically not flight. That's falling with style.
Yeah. Being able to stay up for long periods of time. Just avoiding enemies completely.
That'd be more useful in, like, Super Paper Mario, I feel, because that game has a vastly different, like, combat system.
It's a platformer.
And, like, just gameplay in general. So, you're gonna be pissed off by this, but I checked to see if the Navigator guys, whoever the fuck, did, like, a review of Donkey Kong Country 2.
Yeah.
And they did, and they were like... Yeah, this game's good, but it's nowhere near the hype as the first game.
Yeah.
And I'm like, why? It's the same game except better.
Just like, I guess because it wasn't a precedent.
I guess they're like, but at the end of the day, they're like saying, oh, totally play this game, but they were being like critical about it. They're trying to be like legitimate reviewers.
Yeah.
But I couldn't buy it because they said the music in the second game was worse than the one in the first game.
Oh.
Which is just straight up wrong.
Yeah.
So.
I realize we haven't done any battles since we equipped these patches.
Yeah, you might want to show off how... 5 damage. That's 10 damage.
Bye. Oh, I missed one.
Yeah, well, good news. You got that guy. A life stream and 2 booze sheets. You're really prepared.
Oh, that actually did. I forgot we have a attack up partner badges too.
Yeah. So for Danger Mario, you either gotta be really good with that B Wonder Guard.
Well, no. Normally we would have like a bunch of close call badges and just never get hit ever. But that takes some grinding.
But first you need the one character, the hidden character, and then...
Yeah, so that'll be something that... If I feel like doing more grinding, I can do after this stream.
It's fine, do what you want, man.
Just so we have the badges.
Remember, we're all about that content.
I just liked doing this because it was a different way to play it than the normal.
Yeah, because normally with an RPG, the strategy is just... Get ultra strong, increase those stats. You got numbers? Are those numbers really high? No, make them higher. This one, it's more like, no. The philosophy in that, with this kind of play is, okay, not all numbers matter, these numbers matter.
Yeah. And we could also play around with other different types of builds that were are doable before the very end game, like that one I talked about.
Yeah. Be interesting, just go try to go to the pit of 100 trials with the specific build and see how that works. And if that fails, we just switch to another build.
There's one that, you know, is themed around boosting your partners. And you do have to have quick change, because otherwise, if you have a partner out that can't attack, you're kind of fucked.
So is that one, Mario's Angels? Is that what you would call that build?
Sure, that works. I think the...
Good morning, girls. Good morning, Mario.
Good morning.
Morning, sorry.
I think what the guide called it was spare tire.
Spare tire. Oh, because the guys are... The partners are psychic. They whirl around. They set things on fire with their minds.
Clearly. I'm sure that was what he's going for.
No. I say spare tire because if a partner gets bested, another one's there to pick up the slack. Kind of rotate them out like tires.
What could this be?
What? Oh. This...
There's an invisible thingy here.
The dragon is not dead. Oh. Oh, is that the rare badge that she wanted?
Yep.
Sound badge. What does it sound like?
I don't know. I don't think we can actually equip it. No, it's a key item.
So we'll never know what that sounds like.
No, we do get it after completing the thing.
Oh, so it's just two separate items, technically, then. Just
yeah.
Key item, FX badge B, and then actual badge, FX badge B.
Alright, can I jump down? No?
No.
Oh, but I could jump down from the giant tree in Paper Mario 1.
Yeah, well, I guess being able to survive heights, it depends on what Mario game he's in.
Yeah.
If he's in, like, a 2D platformer, it doesn't matter. If it's in, like, a 3D Mario platformer, oh, you better not.
Yeah, I guess Mario 64 did introduce fall damage for the first time.
They shouldn't have. Like, why would they introduce, like, have a Mario game with fall damage? I guess
they were the most... Paper Mario 64 was also the first game that had a lot of verticality, to bear in mind.
Yeah.
Because the other Mario games were all, you know, strips of level.
Yeah, they were all about the horizontal.
Even Mario 2, which was vertical themed, but it spanned across multiple maps, so you weren't falling any massive distance on a single map.
Mario 3 also had like some levels which was all about traversing up like vertical. Like those
Pipe World. Yeah, I know the one you're talking about.
Like you had to go on platforms and stuff. Other than those, I don't remember anything from Mario 3. All those dead bodies.
Nope.
Speaking of dead bodies, Magic has a new set coming out soon. Called
Zombies?
Amon Ket.
Is it about the... Are the twins involved? Or the brother and sister or whatever?
No, guys? This is a different plane. The plane is called Amon Ket.
Yeah?
Well, you're down to... Three? What's your life at now? Three. Okay.
Amon? Like the Equalist?
Amon Ket. It's an Egyptian plane.
Oh.
Like, so one of the keywords they revealed is embalm.
Yeah.
And that one is basically if you got a creature card and it's in the graveyard, you can choose to embalm it. You can bring it back as a zombie.
Yeah.
You can, like, put a zombie token down.
Oh, that's cool, I guess.
It is pretty cool. It's like, oh, you served me in life, you served me in death now.
Yeah.
But as a mechanic rather than just as necromancer bullshit.
Yeah.
Now, what little I've seen of the set seemed pretty cool, so. I mean, not as cool as Danger Mario, though.
Yeah.
Being able to face tank damage and avoid attacks like crazy.
It'll be a lot cooler when we can actually get the badges that it needs.
Yeah.
Ah, spikes, I don't give a fuck.
I don't know, being able to deal 6 damage is pretty cool.
Yeah, it's still good for now. I actually, after I did the grinding, the Piantas, I realize this is a pretty fun game, so I just randomly felt like playing more on my own completed file. And the only thing that I haven't done on that file is max level. I've matched badge points, but not everything.
Oh, so you're basically just grinding to go up to level 99.
But the thing is, once you get to that point of even just maxing badge points, which is only one third of the max level, you're already at a point where the only enemies in the game who are worth any star points are at the very bottom of the Pit of 100 Trials.
Ah, so you went down the Pit of 100 Trials again.
Yeah, I did, but...
Oh.
Oh, I did I... Okay, I need to talk to him directly. Up arrow.
Here's your up arrow.
What's this? An up arrow?
The seven deities told me this would come. This day would come.
An up arrow?
They gave me a premonition.
Up? Of course!
Yeah, I am high.
I need to inflate a bunch of balloons. Huh?
Up, of course. That's right. I remember now. That's where I put that thing.
So that's what it meant. I forgot it was in my attic.
I picked this up at a flea market. And now it's here. And now I'm gonna use it. Why didn't I have this down here before? It's a mystery.
We are cooking now!
Oh, well.
I'm gonna get Ms. Mouse first. I mean, I'm gonna get her badge that I'm gonna win from her for completing the mission.
Can drop the act. The jig is up.
Yeah.
You're in cahoots with a known criminal. I guess. It doesn't seem like the cops don't give a shit about her, like,
what
badge
cops?
Thievery. Yeah. Yeah, you got me there. There doesn't seem to be any cops around here. Any kind of law enforcement.
What's Gumbella have to say?
It's just two gangs.
The closest thing to cops are the mafia gang.
Yeah, it's like, imagine Hong Kong, but instead of police, it's just the triad.
Yeah. Nope, I'm keeping it.
That
means
the drugs would be legal there, right?
I assume so, yeah.
Like, okay.
I was the one who hid that badge. It was a test. Maybe if I follow you...
Apparently, from what I heard...
I can find more badges.
In Hong Kong... Like, the triads don't mess with, like, tourists and stuff. Because they know that if they did, it'd be bad for business.
Yeah.
Which is like, you know, because of criminals, but I can respect that.
So she kisses Mario and forces Gumbella in the hole.
See, if you're watching this, this is what we call cuckweening.
Yeah.
It's the opposite of cuckolding. Where, like, a guy is stealing another guy's girlfriend, it's a girl stealing another girl's boyfriend.
So there was a badge in the first game that basically did this, is it would tell you if you were near, like, a secret panel or something. But this game you have Ms. Mouse
to
do it.
She's talking about herself.
Yep.
Like, Gumbella isn't... Or, never mind.
I solved the trouble.
Alright.
So we now have our defense piercing partner.
Yeah. We didn't have... Did we have one? Oh, Watt was the last one.
Yeah.
And she... Was it a she or was it a he? I don't remember.
The game couldn't decide but most cases referred to her as a she.
They were really good at...
It only said he once and she a bunch of times, so I'm going to say she. Okay.
Then yes, we're cis scum, I don't care.
What?
Because does cis scum even mean? CIS scum.
Hey, Toadsworth, I forgot you were in this game.
Yeah, you're not necessary, Toadsworth. Like, I don't know. What?
Okay,
you're
well,
stuck in this hotel doing nothing.
Until we finish this chapter, I don't think any of the other Trouble Center things are actually worth it, so let's just go on.
Alright. Alright, how are you gonna get the danger stuff? Where do they...
I mean, we can't.
Where do they normally, roam?
Oh, I mean the...
The wild danger badges.
One of them is on the Goomba family, and one of them's on the Hyper Goomba family.
Okay. Sounds good.
So if I were to grind, those were what I would be grinding. But...
Alright.
I just meant move on to the actual chapter.
Sure, why not? You sure? You think your incomplete build will do for this chapter?
I mean, if not, we can always change it.
Fair enough.
Nope, not strong enough. I need ultra. There's Bobbery stuff we can do. Uh-oh!
Took you by surprise. Woo! Nice.
Oh, right, so after Bowser's army confrontation, there are now Bowser minions in the sewers.
Oh, Bowser's teaming up with the local, slum dogs.
Or I guess he's just got his guys searching for the crystal stars or something.
How many, lucky badges do you have?
I think two. I have two luckies and two close calls.
That should be good. Almost.
Oh, I forgot to power these guys up.
Yeah.
We'll do that before leaving.
I don't want a backseat play.
Oh, hey, I can still get badge points or star points from them. Just,
you're about as scatterbrained as I am today.
Well, we got a lot of stuff to do this chapter. A lot of mini. Oh, fuck you guys.
You gonna take him out? Got it.
I guess if I wanted a little more boost, I could use Jumpman. Just forsake the hammer completely.
Well, no. You don't know when that'll come in handy. Skillful. Such power.
The only reason we ever really need the hammer is for Quake Hammer on ceiling enemies. I don't think there are any of those.
Well, if you have Tornado, like, jump, then that won't even be a problem, because you can just use that.
I don't know if that works on ceiling enemies or not.
Why wouldn't it?
I don't know, because they're not. It's
like,
advertised
it works on all ground, well.
It advertises that it works on airborne enemies.
So if you stick to the ceiling, you're A-okay. Oh, hey, there's a classic. These guys were annoying in the last game.
Yeah, they're weaker in this game. They're a little bit earlier than Bowser's castle.
That's because you killed all the experts. The rest have to pick up the slack.
These are the apprentices.
Yeah.
And multiply? Yep, you fucker.
Oh, well. Oh, I thought that was something you should be worried about.
Okay.
Is that how you want to play? Oh, one. One left.
Still alive.
He's gonna heal.
Okay.
Oh, I thought that was gonna be something serious.
Just flailing desperately to stay alive.
Wow. You've impressed me. But alas, you gotta die. Sorry.
Here we go. I'm cleaning up stuff in the sewers.
Oh, you're just killing a bunch of people in the sewers.
Oh, we actually haven't gone to the door yet.
Yeah, we one thing at a time. You want to level up your partners first?
We're going to go back up to the surface after we go to the door.
All right.
But first...
You don't seem to have a clear, game plan for this video.
We've got this, we've got one more thing we can get in the sewers, and there's and we've got the door.
Okay.
And power up partners.
Oh, fuck. Just pretend I'm not here.
Oh, right, I forgot to,
Yeah, we should see what that does.
I'm gonna try it.
Okay. If it doesn't end up working out, well, you know what to do. Just have the one.
Yeah.
And see what happens.
Oh, the strategy I mentioned that's all about, like, returning pain to your attackers.
Uh-huh.
That actually is the one use that there is for the double pain badge.
Oh, because...
take more damage, they take more damage.
That makes so much sense. That's brilliant. Once I bounce.
But we're spiked! How can you do?
Rubber ducky, you're the one.
What?
It sounds like a fucking rubber duck.
Oh, the bad sound effect.
Yeah.
Damn it.
Get with the program. This. I'm glad that it doesn't say danger on 5.
Yeah, that would get annoying. That would be like the Pokemon ding 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 ding
yeah.
ding.
Red bar.
Speaking of which, I saw that apparently Pokemon Moon is a measly $30 right now, not the outrageous $60 that games are going for these days.
Huh. Well, you mentioned this last night.
So I actually just bought Pokemon Moon.
Good. Good luck trying to stream it.
I'm not going to be able to stream it, sadly, but I need like another $250 to mod my 3DS.
No, I guess that's how you play those.
Mario 2, The Very Old Door, is one of my favorite PlayStation games. Mine too, quality trash. Mine too.
Alternate universe where Mario went to Sony instead.
Yeah.
And then Nintendo
crash
got
to
Crash.
Sega. Oh, sure, yeah.
Oh, no. Okay, Mario went to Sony, Crash went to Sega, and Sonic went to Nintendo.
Yeah.
And so you had Paper Sonic, The Thousand-Year Door.
You know what? I could see that. Sonic could just very easily fit into this system. He'd have jump and he'd have spin dash.
Yeah. Spin dash being the ground. And then, I guess...
It'd be like playing as Cooper, who could jump.
God. And then Eggman. You know what? Eggman in this game would make more sense than Bowser in this game, honestly.
I sit on my pedestal
and wait
for victims.
Oh, no. Oh yeah, that guy's a different color. Is he like a special enemy?
Yes.
Yeah, don't fuck with him.
Why? Because Eggman it fucks around with. Oh
no!
Oh, with old ancient magic. I want.
You might want to steal it first. What's the worst that could happen?
Well, that's what I'm trying to. I'm stealing.
Yeah.
But. Okay, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna wait a turn.
You're gonna tell. Oh, so you're gonna block her.
Yeah, I'm gonna put her in front.
Okay. And then take out.
Ow.
Yeah, that hurts. That's pretty better.
Ow.
That's so good. Good job. You're not gonna tattle on him, but fuck it.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, you're right. I can switch back after stealing.
Yeah. Then the Gubella can...
Oh! It got the effect of the badge. Fuck it.
You're just gonna...
Tank
Gubella. Kill all the other ones, and then...
Yeah, I can do that. That's my plan.
You got a life shroom, yeah?
I think.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, I do. But I don't want to waste... I don't want to waste it on Gubella. That sounds really mean to Goombella, doesn't it?
Yeah.
That's a Spewnia! Its body is made up of three discs. 12, 7, 2, made a hit of 100 trials, but that's not where we are!
The pit is opening. The enemies are leaking out. Better get investigators together. Call Delta Green.
Damn it! Okay, well, one life stream down.
Jeez, man.
My action commands are off. I had that.
You mentioned it's the TV's fault. I had imagined you would have adapted by now, but then again, I'm not you, so. Alright, you gonna attempt again?
I will seduce the beast!
You did it.
Mine.
Okay. That's a great eye twinkle animation, by the way.
Those are both good badges, too. Those are actually gonna sync well with Danger Mario. So we just improved our build.
Alright, you're out of danger now.
Yeah, just these fuckers.
Okay.
Pokemon Moon is only $30. Yes, it is. On Amazon.
If you have any...
God damn it, you fuck.
Oh, wait. Somebody's doing something.
Oh, nope.
You got any, FPF items? No, yeah, of course you don't.
FPI? What do you mean? Oh, no, yeah.
You're gonna have to get a treat. You don't have access to the feast yet, do you?
I do.
Oh, no, you do. Okay, fuck it. Have a feast.
We finally worked out the tweaks. There are no more poison mushrooms. I don't know why we put them in the move to begin with.
Because it needs to be balanced. God.
Ah, oh, there are some actually. Damn it, you fuck.
Oh, it's much better. Look at those ups.
Yeah.
15, 15, 20. You basically maxed yourself out.
The star bill actually is kind of amazing because I read that apparently you can get enough Super Peel badges to stack them, because those are another badge that you can buy at the Pianta Parlor.
Oh, really?
You can get like 20 or 30 of them and instantly refill from zero star power with one appeal.
That's great.
And the only reason I wouldn't do that is because, you know, star moves take up so much time.
Yeah. But that does sound amazing. Just earthquaking in reality, punching your way to victory, and then every time you're remotely low, you can just do sweet feasts, and then that's it.
We do that in the Shadow Temple. Just Star Mario. Oh god, that chapter would take forever that way.
Yeah. No, just... It take as much time as it would for Goku to defeat an enemy in Dragon Ball Z.
Yeah.
Take weeks.
Oh, so I was gonna say something.
Imagine watching fucking Dragon Ball Z and like one episode a week.
Oh god. There's a reason Toonami did two at a time.
Yeah, two at a time, 5 days in a row. Because they knew, it's like, well, we could either do it the way they...
Meh.
Plus. Yeah, that's kind of not what we're going for this time.
Gonna have to come back for that. There's probably a way that you can, like, glitch onto that and get it, but I don't know.
I'm pretty sure. We have to ask Striker X7.
Strider.
Strider X7. Striker. Just imagine that Mortal Kombat cop. Just talking about Paper Mario.
Is there a Mortal Kombat character named Striker?
Yes. Yeah, he's like a guy in riot gear, and he's got a gun.
Oh. I thought of like Super Mario Strikers. Which I've never
like
played
soccer.
And know nothing about except that Daisy's got a fine ass.
I played it, it's not bad actually.
Yeah.
For a soccer game. It plays pretty fun.
Sonic Soccer. Can you imagine that? Everything would be at, like, light speed.
Oh, God.
Silence.
You know what exists? Mega Man Soccer.
Oh, does it?
Yeah, is it for SNES? I've never played it. But it exists.
Sorry, door. Gonna have to wait. We'll be right back. The last thing in the sewers is just in one room over here.
I guess they realized that at some point that
oh, no, we already got
having
that.
The same old enemies be in the sewers is a bad idea, so they're just like, hey, these guys are here now.
Well,
Bowser.
Especially since they were Goombas and Spinias and things that were, you know, 2 and 3 hit points. Kind of outdated by this point.
Something that could be destroyed with a stiff breeze.
Yeah.
A stiff breeze, light hail, and...
I should keep Yoshi out more, because I forget that with the partner attack power-up badges, he hits the most times, and so he benefits the most from those.
Oh, in that case, he's our berserker.
So he's going to get, like, 5 3 attack hits.
Oh, that's good. How many stars do we have left? 2?
2. We're on chapter 6.
So, next chapter is Midnight Train, and the chapter after that is...
A Secret. We're gonna raid the X-Nauts for their star.
Oh yeah, that's right. The moon base raid.
Oh, but that was a secret. That one's gonna suck. Because that one has the chase the dude around quest.
Oh. Oh yeah, that one. Fuck that one.
Worst part of the game.
Just a small town girl.
Oh, that's one, I don't know if you knew this, but aside from the cool, let's cruise back and check in with the prof.
Yep.
Aside from the usual version differences between Sun and Moon of different legendaries and different wild Pokemon encounters, they made a difference in that in... good news, everyone!
I was expecting him to go, what? And I it hit me with the Farnsworth. Great, good news, everyone.
Sun and moon are a 12-hour different time clock.
Oh yeah, that's right, you told me this.
So, whenever it's day in sun, it's night in moon. Or whenever, like, moon is the opposite of real world time.
So if you play moon...
in the day, it's nighttime. And if you play at night, it's daytime.
Which one did you get? Did you get sun or moon?
I got moon.
Why?
Because I like the legendary better. Dude, you want moon?
I wanted sun.
Just because you stay up late?
I wanted sun because I'm a sunny... I have a sunny personality.
Oh man, are there oodles of rich and famous people?
Oh, we're going to fucking Ropanagi?
We're going to Hollywood.
We're going.
And my family shows us also shine.
I told you about not Ropanagi, it's Roppongi.
Oh, a shine to the stars. Star worship is back.
Yeah, these guys, the primary religion of this universe is that they worship stars.
It's just a tourist attraction.
Like a bunch of freaks.
Ropanagi?
Sorry, not Ropanagi. Roppongi is what I'm thinking.
Roppongi, what's that?
Roppongi. That's a town or district or something in Japan.
Yeah.
It's like filled with all these like nightclubs and like high-rise buildings and rich people and stuff.
Oh.
It's also home to a lot of Yakuza activity.
So that's
probably
where,
because of the same reasons.
So that's where the major lives, right?
I think.
With their harem of girlfriends.
lives in Roppongi.
In a penthouse suite.
I know, I
Can
only...
Can cyborgs have sex? Do you want to find out?
Another time. Another time, obvious kid.
13-year-old kid.
The major don't give no fucks. Except for that one, I guess.
Yeah. Oh, right, Yoshi wasn't here the last time we met Don Pianta. I've heard stories about that loon!
So, here's a question.
No pun guy.
Roppongi... I've heard of Roppongi not from an anime, but from a tag team who called themselves Roppongi Vice.
Roppongi? Roppongi?
Roppongi is how they pronounce it.
Hmm.
I could be wrong, though. But, yeah, it's basically two white guys. Well, a white guy and a vaguely black dude. But I know they're not Japanese. It's Beretta and Rocky Romero.
Yeah.
And I'm like, Roppongi Vice. Is it like Miami Vice or actually cops?
Yeah.
That'd be pretty cool.
Cop Yakuza.
Cop Yakuza wrestlers. Because that's what Miami Vice was about. They were basically just a couple of cops that used the loophole in, like, American law to get shit from drug dealers. Like, if a drug dealer is, like, caught in, like, commission of a crime...
Yeah?
They get, like... steal their shit. It's a problem even in modern day.
So, were you looking up, like, Miami Vice stuff because of Artificial Academy or before Artificial Academy?
Why do you say that?
Because the first time you mentioned it was Artificial Academy, and now you're mentioning it again, so I assume you've been looking up stuff or something?
Well, we were talking about Rich People Town, and that's why I mentioned it again, because I was reminded of Roppongi, but... the first time I actually caught this channel on YouTube called Lasagna Cat.
Yeah.
Guess what it's about?
Garfield?
Yes. It's like these guys doing live action reenactments of Garfield strips. And then afterwards they do like a parody of the strip in like this weird surreal style.
Oh, okay.
And there was one involving like John tricking Garfield to thinking he was temporarily Odie by just using a frame instead of a mirror.
Yeah.
And then they just and then for the show, for like the after strip reenactment parody, they just reenacted a popular scene from the pilot of Miami Vice.
Yeah.
But with the both of them dressed as Garfield and Odie, and John was involved.
Yeah.
And a weird ass cover of Phil Collins' "In the Air Tonight" by the main voice actor for Rick and Morty.
Oh, what's that guy's name?
Yeah, him.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
And I'm like, this is some really high production values because it doesn't look like shit. It looks actually really good.
Yeah.
And that's why I'm reminded of Miami Vice. go on really weird tangents.
Yeah.
Maybe.
It's in the Ishmael house.
Mario and Luigi as cops. It's like,
I can imagine that.
Well, they're both. Well, he's wearing blue. They both wear blue. They're like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They basically are the cops of the Mushroom Kingdom.
Mushroom Vice. Or no, MK Vice.
In our versions of Kenpachi and Kuratsuchi are basically buddy cops, right?
Yeah, they're Sarate Vice.
Yeah. Something here? No.
just imagine Kenpachi with like his spiky bell hair and Kuratsuchi with his face paint, just dressed in like detective suits, just and in like a top-down car.
Yeah.
Now. Buddy cop duo. Detective Kenpachi, we've received word of a murder.
Oh, I guess we better take care of it. Who do we need to kill?
One that wasn't yours.
Kenpachi, we don't kill people on the force. We arrest them.
Oh, so we can fight them.
In court.
Trial by combat. My favorite.
Oh, damn it, that's right. I forgot I'm in the human world.
Trial bike.
Oh. Sure, fuck it. More attack effects.
You spit all your coins on a fucking effects badge.
There's one that does, like, the thwomp sound.
Oh, is there... I guess the orgasmic one isn't in this game.
No, they probably removed that.
They're like, no...
They put that out on the N64, and then a year later, their one guy was like, you know, this badge sounds like someone coming.
ESRB was like, hey, should we check the effects badges? Fuck it. Let's get lunch.
Get a tweet from Shigeru Miyamoto. I hear that some of you people have been using a badge in Paper Mario that sounds like orgasms.
Oh,
Please do not do that.
Okay, you spent all your money on...
And then I came to look here, yes.
And then, yeah...
Power Rush P. Those are all P badges, not useful for us.
Super appeal.
Oh, that's right. I should equip Pretty Lucky.
Yeah, you need it. You can now. Good news, everyone. You're luckier.
P plus.
You don't want to get rid of the power stuff.
Pretty Lucky. Okay, so that's two.
Two's pretty good. I wouldn't get rid of Spike Shield.
Where are we going? We're not going to need ice power anytime soon. Multi-bounce is kind of critical.
Power bounce we don't really use anyway.
Nah, if it comes to like we're in a boss battle and we need it, we can equip it.
In the meantime, whatever.
Lucky. So I could either have a happy heart or...
Does HP train do?
Every time you get a hit, you regain a hit point, but you lose one attack power.
Oh. Nah. That's not good,
You know what? I've spent enough time at low hit point, I'm gonna put Happy Heart back on.
Wait, so no chill out?
Yeah.
Why not?
Because, I'll level up and get another badge point to spare, and then I'll put that back on.
Okay. Fair enough. Let's take a midnight train, then. Going anywhere. Anywhere.
What was the other really big Journey song?
Any way you want.
Yeah, that was
it. That's the way you need it. Any way you want.
I think I downloaded like two or three of them. I mean, bought legally. Totally.
Yeah, you downloaded it from a site which sells them. Bandcamp.
Yeah. I bought them.
They're on Bandcamp, right?
I bought them from the YouTube song store. Oh, right, I gotta get the tickets first. This is a thing.
Oh, yeah, you gotta buy tickets from your mob connections. Roppongi.
Because I'm Italian.
Roppongi lights. Roppongi fights. This is basically just you. Getting favors for mob boss to go down to Roppongi.
Yeah. This is nicer area than Roppongi though. It's more like Beverly Hills.
That's where I want to be.
Oh, poor boss. The big man's been sick with loneliness.
I'm glad Ratso got a new job after he left the Enforcers.
Yeah. What's he doing?
He's...
They were at a petting zoo. And
yeah, they were doing community service.
Oh, yeah, that's what it was.
And then they decided they were going to steal a statue despite the fact they knew they would fuck up.
You guys but are janitors?
Did. But they did, and they're going to prison, and they'll be out in 6 months. Because Captain Black is bad at his job.
Yeah.
So, he's sad because his son-in-law and his daughter are gone, right?
But we know where they're at.
So we gotta go back to the island and fetch them.
Yep. No, fuck you. Deal!
Take a hike, bub. Like, a deal that's advantageous to you.
Then
like,
you get a
no,
game over. The mob like, slashes you.
The mob... They find Mario's corpse hanging from a rafter. And then... And they pulled his tongue out through his throat.
Sounds like a good time. Oh! Don't mind me, little toad. I'm just raiding your house while your mom's off gambling.
It's actually a really nice house. Look at that shit.
Pop.
Oh, hey. Do you have the shine sprites there simply to just pimp out sunshine?
Ready to get weird! I'm in your drawer.
Okay, so there's a hole in the...
In the guy's...
That would mean that there's not only a hole in the wall, but also a hole in the drawer.
Do you think he makes drug deals through there?
This is fuck... This is
with people in the back alley?
This is Roppongi Hills. I'm... No, Roppongi's the place we're going to. We're actually in Beverly Hills right now.
Make back alley drug deals without ever leaving your home.
It's pretty brilliant, actually. Like, you just get a text from somebody who's like, I'm here, can you deposit the drugs? The money's in the drawer. You open the drawer, the money's there, and you just remove it. You put, like...
It's like those safety drawers at the bank.
It's pretty brilliant. Like, plus you're not actually meeting with somebody, so the cops... I guess if it was actually, like, a cop, that'd be a problem, because then they know where you live.
Yeah. What, drugs? I don't know how they got there. Someone just dropped him in my backyard.
That's,
I had nothing to do with
see,
it.
See, that's why you need, like, a fake back for your drawer.
Yeah.
And then they'll go in, and then they'll see that the drawer's there, and it's like, what? Don't be silly. It's covered. It's always been covered.
Gotta take a 3-day boat ride to an island I just came back from before I can go to the next chapter.
Yeah, that's because there's no pipe that goes here, is there?
There is.
Oh, well, okay.
But we need to get the final boots and hammer before we can access it. In case you missed this music from the last video.
Yeah. Back to the jungle. Hey, why are you out in the middle of nowhere?
Oh, we live here now. It's nice.
Here, there's no house. You're also still in a suit.
We gotta go back and get the boss. No, oh, I lost my wedding ring. We have to find it.
My little bacon boy get.
You're going to have to say you love me 100 times. I wish she was joking. They ran out of ideas, right? If this chapter we gotta do this, and next chapter we gotta chase around...
We're not going to get into the chapter by the end of this, I feel.
Chase around
not
the...
Not today.
Chase around the bomb fucker in the next chapter. General White.
I feel like this is just the developers deciding, you know what... We gotta fuck with the player. We'll make him hit a button 100 times. Because fuck him. You must say it 100 times.
You're such a silly belly.
But you were serious. Don't play it off like that, lady.
Alright. I gotta do all the... I got to do all the shit around here
myself. I've got very bad injuries, and I've probably got a terminal disease, but I'll do it.
Mario's got terminal 5.
Terminal 5, because he's got 5 hit points left. He'll have terminal 2, and that'll be 2 hit points left.
Oh, they still got, Spike still alive. Meh.
Frame rate on those were really good.
Yeah, way better than when they summoned stars in the last game.
Yeah, that actually... Well, that's because that game had... The hardware couldn't handle the glory of our star gods.
Yeah.
This game can, because it's got hardware blessed with the power of...
Well, they're not
stars. Keep on keeping on, buddy.
Yeah. He's still just hanging out there, having fun. Having a good time, having a good time!
Don't stop me now, I'm having such a good time. Properly blessed. Each the thing is factory assembled, and you got a star priest there to perform the sacrament. How could you lose a wedding ring? No, it's easy. Never mind.
Oh, let me just... I can't quite reach this coconut. Let me just take off our wedding ring so it'll strengthen my grip.
See, my parents had the opposite problem. They're, like, my dad had, like, couldn't remove his ring for, like, the longest time. He had to... And it was, like, interfering with his circulation after a while, so he had to, like, get it cut off and resized.
Oh, the ring.
Yeah. Not the finger. Yeah, my dad amputated his finger. It ruined his career as a chef.
Yeah.
No,
Well, which finger? Because some are more important than others.
But yeah, he removed it. My mom found out, and rather than being all, I actually don't know what happened. I just know my dad was like, yeah, she wasn't too happy about it.
Yeah, I'm like, surprised he didn't tell her before doing it.
Well, if you're surprised by that, you don't know Mr. Friction very well.
Back to Rogueport, another 3-day trip.
It took me sick. Oh, I hope he's still alive. They get back and they're burying his body in the ditch or something.
Who? Mario?
No, the boss.
Oh yeah. Luigi's still standing there.
Yeah, I've been doing nothing in these past 6 days.
There's gonna be, over in that area where Luigi's standing, there's going to be, like, a business rat.
So you said the other guy was,
Okay, don't let me finish.
Sorry, business rat, I know.
Who you can invest oil with and actually get a big return on.
Wait,
but there are stocks in Paper Mario.
No, that's just an investment opportunity. Actual stocks would be boring as sin.
Yeah. What are you gonna say?
Like, that dude that's with Luigi, you said he was, like, a filmmaker or something?
Stage director.
Like, if he was a filmmaker, then he can just have... Then he's just there for 6 days because he's doing, like, a... Like, an experimental film.
Yeah?
You know, like how Andy Warhol filmed this guy getting a blowjob from the waist up.
Okay.
Or, like, just from the face.
Yeah.
Or just, like, he filmed the Empire State Building for, like, 48 hours.
Yeah.
And that's it.
There's people watching.
Then he did, like, that really, really terrible, like, adaptation. Intentionally so, of, Clockwork Orange before Clockwork Orange was a thing.
Yeah.
And he called it Vinyl.
Oh.
It was, like, all filmed in one shot. Andy Warhol was weird.
He was. I think I did a project on him in, like, middle school. So, the boss is retiring.
Retiring?
Yep. I'm not gonna be a mob boss anymore. It's up to you, Frankie. You're the head of the family now.
But, you can't retire... You think... He has to be given an impossible task.
Oh, you promised him train tickets. Is that all? You had me worried for a second. I thought we had to off a guy.
Off a guy.
You want? I want you to kill Luigi and like let me collect the life insurance.
The boss has retired. And then like 10 years later, he's like, I heard you struck my son. That's right, sir. I did. May I ask why? Cause he stole the former Don's car, sir, and slapped his daughter.
Oh.
Oh.
You ever think about joining up with a syndicate? No, I'm good.
I'm already part of the family. So it's the Hawaiian mob versus the Italian, well, teaming up with the Italian mob.
Yeah, sure. They haven't really, there hasn't really been any, like, turf war shenanigans since that one scene at the start of the game. Like, the snail mafia has kind of just kept to themselves the rest of the game.
It's a very chill place for a slum.
Yeah.
Like, usually with slums, it's like, you're expecting somebody to just jump out the window at any moment and just beat the crap out of you.
Boo! Speaking of jumping out.
Oh, you should have picked Vivian.
Yeah. You live for now. And so they're off to Poshley.
That's a missed opportunity.
Big mouth Yoshi.
Hey Vivian, your sister dropped by. Oh, what did she say?
Yeah, it's
yeah,
just
that
like
sounds
her.
Like her. Damn it. Frank did my joke.
Sorry.
Yeah.
We said the same thing,
yeah.
Basically. Oh, did we? We got the cookbook. I guess I should give that to...
We had this a while ago, but you were being kind of a bitch with the contact, so...
I got the lowdown on a book that can turn anyone into a master chef!
Oh, this chef
whips
note.
It out.
The chef note. You write down what you want, and then you cook it perfectly.
Do I not have the book? I thought I had it.
No. Yes.
Okay, I think there's actually a trouble in the trouble center that she puts up. That you have to accept and then talk to her in order to give her the cookbook.
I don't have the book. I have the book here. I don't have the book. But I have the... You don't understand. I don't have the book.
I gotta trigger the flag first. Alright, I can...
You go to the trouble center. I don't have the book. I'll give her the book. Do you have the book? Yes. Oh, thank you.
And Ms. Mouse? Oh, and she can, she learned Smooch and can give Mario hit points.
So we got a healer now.
Yeah, White Mage. The White Mage and
the White
Thief.
White Robe Mage.
Yeah. The White Robe.
It's like you got a guy dressed as a priest, but he's also really skilled with, like, thievery stuff. Like parkour.
So, Zelos?
That's a secret.
The roguish priest, Zelos, appears.
The guy who even the protagonists don't want to mess with. We could, it's like that one guy's like, we could take him, and Lena's like, no, we can't.
Yeah.
Just steer clear of him. Which actually goes a long way to sealing like a reputation of a character. If you want like somebody, if you want to build up a character, you just have other guys go, oh, that's Joe. We don't mess with Joe. And then you see somebody messing with Joe, and then Joe like punches his gut so hard he's crippled or something. He's like, we gotta get out of here.
Yeah. Yeah, I was hoping the next trouble center thing that you can do for a Pianta Parlor coupon is something with Frankie and Francesca. So I was hoping once we finish that, maybe it would be available.
But
it's
not.
So, gonna have to finish the chapter first.
No. So you realistically can't, like, get Danger Mario built up until chapter 8, then?
Until chapter 7.
But I thought this was chapter 7.
This is chapter 6.
Oh. Okay, then. What are we making?
I don't know. I gave her a cookbook. I guess she's gonna cook it.
A cookbook? Awesome! So she eats it.
Mario's just leaning, confused.
What?
Honey shroom, I'm gonna guess. Yep.
So before, she didn't think to do that. She just chopped up onions, threw them in a pan, and then just set the heat up.
She was a traditional ramen supremacist. She would not mix in anything else with her one ingredient.
Then the ramen got sad about it and decided to declare war on all the other ramen stores.
Yeah.
Tragic times. The ramen wars were really brutal.
Brutal
almost,
stuff.
It was brutal in Japan, almost as brutal as America's franchise wars.
Yeah.
Ever tell you that story?
Which franchise wars?
Okay, so there's this movie called Demolition Man. It takes place in, like, far future of America. Yeah. And in a time in which 1990 was the future of America and everything was all shit.
Yeah.
Sylvester Stallone, like, saves a guy. Or, like, you know, he catches a criminal. But yeah. The criminal is like, oh, he killed a bunch of people. And they took the criminal at his word. They threw him, like, a cryo tube. Type deal.
Yeah.
And he woke up years later, and the only restaurant in the future was Taco Bell.
Oh, okay.
That was the only one. And then Sylvester Stallone's like, why is there... I can't do a Stallone accent.
What's that eat about here?
Why is there only a... He's like, why is there only a Taco Bell? And then the buddy cop he's with, this hot chick.
Yeah.
Played by someone, I don't remember. He's like, oh, Taco Bell was the only one who survived the franchise wars.
Oh.
And it's like, that and don't you think I've exhausted every other option? That's a line with a story.
Yeah.
It's like, did McDonald's get into an arms race with fucking Burger King? And they just decided they were going to declare war on each other? Was there incidents where you'd have, like, suicide bombers and drive-thrus?
Sure.
Just like Ronald McDonald getting lynched by a bunch
right.
of over-enthusiastic Wendy's cosplayers.
Yeah.
Man.
It's like, you know that PS3 Twisted Metal game where it's like a full gang of Sweet Tooths?
Oh,
it's
yeah.
like that, but with Ronald McDonald and the Burger King and shit.
God, the food trucks would have been the first people to go, right? Yeah,
they would have vamoosed like they would have gone to Mexico. Fuck, they're mobile. Okay, so we got a note about warning us to get off the train or a sticky, yummy doom awaits us.
God.
Oh no. We gotta solve this mystery. You know, like the mystery in the last game. That was the most fun part. There was only one thing to do when confronted with a mystery.
You know, I've been on trains a lot. I don't remember this elevator music. Oh no.
Penguins are the best detectives, as we learned in the last game.
He was in the last game, wasn't he?
I don't think so.
Were you?
I don't think that was the same penguin.
Goombella, was it? No? Okay, I guess we're not figuring it out.
I'll ask her later. Okay, I guess tell the conductor.
Conductor, there's a problem. We've...
Good gracious me. If I hear anything else, I'll let you know immediately.
Oh no, somebody's eaten all of the desserts. Who?
Oh, they're gone.
The desserts?
Yes.
Oh, Detective Penguin left.
What's going on here? That's Pennington, a train passenger.
Yeah, he was in the last game.
Was his name Pennington?
I think so.
I'll have to check, I guess. This smells like a case to me. Supper Sue vanished. I'm gonna kind of hurry through this chapter.
Yeah, I don't blame you.
We got an hour, and I'm pretty sure we can finish it, and it's on. Honestly, the train shenanigans are kind of dull.
Yeah. Dun-dun-dun. So, our suspects are...
You gluttonous woman!
Not the chef. Taste... Sweet tea?
Yeah, she's kind of cute. If, you know, toads weren't asexual.
I guess. I just have a feeling Nintendo is saying that to save face.
Yeah.
Like,
I don't think
they say that, but it contradicts everything I've seen in these kinds of games. Like,
You know, all that toad fucking that's been on screen.
Okay, yeah, you're right. Mario hasn't gone full-on Game of Thrones at any point.
I don't think Nintendo thinks ahead with anything they do. Like, Miyamoto said outright, Mario games are all just stage plays.
Yeah. I mean, taken literally in this game. I was joking, did they actually eat the desserts?
It's obviously Mario.
Why?
I thought I had to check it out and then talk to him. So I guess now I just follow the trail.
Okay. And then goes into cart 3 and...
Oh look, it's the fat guy.
Oh, it's Man, gourmet guy really slimmed down. He also lost the mask.
Yeah, turns out he was just a toad. Food gets stolen and you blame the chubby guy, you jerk. There's something under the magazines, a galley pot. How did we miss that the first time? No!
I'm sorry.
I could go for some stew right now.
Oh man, what kind of stew? Like...
What are you doing? It's gumbo. What are you doing, Stu?
Like nice gumbo and.
Sure.
It's four. What are you? What on earth are you doing, Stu? Making stew. It's 4 o'clock in the morning, Stu. Why on earth are you making stew for? Because I have a hankering for some stew. Hey, Angelica, you want some stew? That's okay, Uncle Stu. Stu is doesn't really agree with me. Okay. Not as good as a meme where he's like making chocolate pudding because he hates himself.
Yeah, I remember seeing that episode.
Oh yeah, that was a great episode. Angelica cemented herself as being this like high and mighty bitch.
I'd have to look it up to confirm, but I think I heard that the Rugrats soundtrack, including the theme song, was composed by one of the members of Devo. The band, yes.
It's Devo.
Like, I think it was like the drummer or something.
The Devo, the ones who famously had a one-hit wonder song about jerking off.
Like, what was that song?
When the problem comes along, you must whip it.
Oh, okay.
So, I guess. Like, I could...
You saw, quite obviously, the famed Luigi!
Then again, is...
Let's go.
It's a goal.
What were you gonna say?
So it sounds similar to those same people that are like saying, Relax by Frankie Goes to Hollywood is also about jacking off.
Yeah. And
then, you know, you're turning Japanese.
Yeah.
So I could be wrong. I'll admit that. Oh, it's at night already.
And Let It Go is actually about having to fart.
No, Let It Go is having to piss.
Oh. I think you need to re-listen to the lyrics. Oh, I got a star piece.
The cold never
The wind is
me
howling
anyway.
Like the swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in. Heaven knows I tried.
Alright, then I guess,
Hello, business rat.
Does it make the sound of silence about a guy who recently killed himself?
Sure, why not?
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Song meanings with Jack and Xelrog.
Oh, Bad Romance is about a girl who's trapped in a really bad relationship with a guy, but the sex is really good, so she doesn't want to end it.
Yeah?
I guess.
I prefer a Rancid Romance.
Dun, 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 dun. Oh, that's Lucy Fears and Morningstar, sorry. Yeah. Talking about, Diablo Swing Orchestra. One of my favorite bands.
Yeah.
Because it's just like I showed like the first track of their Pandora Pinata album.
Yeah.
And he listened to the first 10 seconds and he just bursted out laughing.
You showed it to who?
My dad.
Oh.
Mr. Friction. It was just like, this is amazing.
What's the first song on that album?
Voodoo Mon Amore.
Oh.
It's the one where it's like, it begins with hard rock and then goes into swing.
Oh.
Or like hard metal goes into swing. Oh, hello.
Okay, I'll help. Okay, this is where we get like quests from the passengers. Who's in cart number one?
You don't understand. We need seven stars. Why? Can we just have five? No!
It's not good enough. We gotta have seven.
Seven's thematic. We're gonna. It's brilliant. We'll have this next bit on a train. No. A train? It's linear. There's gonna be no combat. There's gonna be combat? No, it's gonna be murder mystery. Oh, that again.
But the stars are, the door's weakening. The stars aren't relevant anymore. No, you gotta have all seven!
And you gotta be, and it's gotta be on a train. We gotta have a giant spider.
Yes.
We gotta have a giant spider in no Superman costume. I'm reminded of those types of people.
Yeah.
They told you that story, right?
What?
Oh, no, I didn't. I tell a lot of stories, both here and at work.
Yeah.
There's this guy, I don't remember his name, but he was, like, tasked with directing, like, a Superman movie.
Yeah.
And I guess Kevin James decided he was gonna assist.
Okay.
You know, of Clerks fame.
As Superman?
Yeah. And, like, not, he wasn't Superman, he was just
Wait, Kevin
the guy
James was in Clerks?
Who's gonna help. What?
Kevin James was in Clerks?
Yeah, he plays Silent Bob, and he's, like, a writer. And, like,
Kevin James was Silent Bob? Kevin Smith.
Kevin Smith.
Kevin James is a totally different dude.
Yeah, you're right. It's Kevin Smith. Sorry. Sorry, Canadian dude. Don't kill me. But, you know, Kevin Smith was doing something with this director. And the director was like, okay, we're going to do Superman, but I got two things. Two requests. He's like, one, we can't have the suit. And Kevin Smith was like, you're going to have a Superman without the iconic suit? That's strange, and but I guess we could work something out. It's like, two, the main villain must be a giant spider.
Yeah.
And that was like really baffling. Of like, wait, what? So then he's like calling like the executives because you know they bankroll shit, and he's like telling them what's going on, and then the executive turned to him and like over the phone signs like. Not that giant spider shit again.
Yeah. Okay, I'm seeing some serious flaws with your movie.
It's just like...
Why would he open the dead zone if it was the one thing that would kill him? Yeah, I kind of rolled myself into a corner there.
Sky giant. Man, this castle's gonna be really good.
So In addition to the crime drama...
Is there a giant spider in Dragon Ball ever?
Can't think of any.
Oh, dear.
So in addition to the train drama shenanigans, the crime drama stuff, we get another one of your favorite tropes is that parents bitching to each other.
Of course.
The bomb parents are arguing about what to get their kid for the kid's birthday, and he doesn't want anything involved. So we're gonna get him the train conductor, the engineer's autograph.
Somebody loves their kid too much.
Yeah.
I guess. No, we're gonna get him. Your guys are rich. Why not just you get him something, you get him something, and then you both go out to like a fucking claim jumpers or something.
Go out to Billigan's.
Like a Chuck E. Cheese. No, that's too low class for these guys.
Apparently. This is a Xelrog family story. Uh-huh. There was my Granny Xelrog went out with the adult members of the family. This was years ago when I was still, you know, like a teenager or something. And they went to Vegas. And
awesome.
They went with.
They should have said hi to my family.
They went with my great aunt. You've met her, the really grouchy one.
Yeah.
The very scowly attitude woman.
Yeah.
I just remembered something suspicious. I was one blanket short.
Somebody stole a blanket. Who cares?
Alright, I'll find your blanket. And they went to Vegas, and they went to this, like, really famous, crazy expensive restaurant where you have to order everything a la carte and each dish is like $10, $20.
That sounds about right.
So, some crazy high-end restaurant. And there was this group of, like, three guys in suits who were there at the next table. Mm-hmm. And were just all extremely drunk, extremely loud, extremely obnoxious the entire time. And the entire restaurant was just up to shit with it. They did not want to...
Nobody.
No one was happy with them. And so they went through the entire dinner that way after paying God knows too much for the food.
Wait, they didn't comp their meals after that?
No.
They should have requested that. Like,
it's a ghost!
It's a ghost. Who don't you? Ooh.
And after they... after they finish the meal, the grouchy aunt is like, if you guys don't want to see this, you'd better go outside.
Oh my god.
And so everyone everyone in the family but her went outside, and she walked over and gave them the biggest earful of their lives.
Yes! Yes!
And no, everyone else had left, so they weren't present for it, but... According to the aunt, the entire restaurant applauded her when she was finished.
I mean, if they have to be really loud for that to happen, but if that happened, I don't believe your family would be...
Your life! I'll take your life. Yeah?
No, just kidding.
I died in this cabin many years ago, but my luggage is still in the baggage car. Why? Do they never clean it out?
There's a diary.
What shitty, like, train conductors?
Also, don't read the diary.
A horrible fate awaits you.
When was the last time you saved?
Now.
Yeah. It doesn't even reveal anything useful. It's just like you see the page and it's
we can check it out.
I guess if you want to.
Going through the train at night. I think this is a 3-day trip.
No, this is day one.
Yeah.
Three days?
Day two is very uneventful.
This is a very unusual location. 3 days from everything. Rogueport. 3 days by sea to the island. 3 days by train to the place.
3 days. 3 days.
Oh my god, Samara's doing speed.
Foods. Gotta get those foods.
Food with S.
Gotta know what's in the crates. It's foods.
Foods. Food S. This is fucking Muzak.
Yep. Sure is that.
It's like...
That is the actual name for the genre of music that is elevator music, by the way.
It's like I'm waiting in line to go ride a Ferris wheel or some shit.
Yeah. 3 whole days of this!
I hope they turn the Muzak off at night.
Yeah.
Like, can you imagine going to sleep and then waking up with that? That would drive you insane.
You just have dreams about, like, a shitty merry-go-round. Hey, look, a diary. Let's read it.
It's the merry-go-round that Drago fucked with.
You don't want to do that. You may be cursed by the ghost. Ah, what the heck. This could be really bad.
I warned you.
I got on a train today. You looked. And then a skeleton jumped out.
And then skeleton popped out.
Well, it's a good thing we saved.
Yep.
It's also a good thing this game doesn't track deaths like Zelda does.
You have died X times. Because you suck. This game is permadeath.
I don't.
There's books and then they're unmarked. And sometimes when you read them, it's just the permadeath ghost and he comes and kills you.
Yeah, that would suck. That would not be good game design.
Yeah, no. That's why I don't. Well, then again, if there's items that allow you to identify books, then that'd be better.
Yeah.
That's what NetHack did. NetHack had like potions that were unmarked. And you could either identify them by drinking them or by, like, other methods. Like, dipping something in the potion and seeing what happens.
Pour it in a little vat of blood. See if it jumps.
The blood?
Yeah.
Just, a guy's like, This guy's like, okay, we're trying to test this vial out. We got blood. Let's see what happens. Just pours it in. It's like, nothing happened. Then the blood just jumps out. That's the jump scare. Is it grow tentacles or something?
Actually, I like it here. The wallpaper's nice. I'm gonna stay.
Okay, guy.
I can leave whenever, so.
The soul chip. This guy is able to con so back to, like, Soul Society, but he's like, nah, I like it here.
What was that scene that they did the blood testing? Was that it burned,
right? That was the thing. Like, they were testing the blood, and it's like, I'll show you what we already know.
Yeah.
We'll do you last, and then they poke the blood and he jumps. Yeah.
Oh, right, I gotta give the blanket back. Can't skip to the next day yet. No matter how much I sleep.
I showed you the frozen variant of that scene, right?
There's a frozen variant?
Yeah, like, it's just that scene, but with frozen characters. And it's what's his name? Hans? Stefan?
I think it was Hans, maybe? I don't know.
The guy friend.
Yeah.
Who isn't the prince? Is doing the testing.
You may have shown me that.
Yeah.
I don't remember.
It turns out Ella was, like, possessed by the thing.
I first saw it from the South Park did a parody of it.
Yeah.
In the, like, lice episode.
Because, like, yeah. God. Matt Stone, Trey Parker.
All right, I'll tell you. All of you have lice. Life spreads fast, you dumb little bitches.
So they killed Kitty for no reason at all.
Yep. Alright, he'll be fine though.
Why does blood do that? Because he's got a lot of sexually transmitted diseases.
Undertale, except it stars Kenny. Power of reset.
I guess, yeah, that was his power.
Although, kind of. It wasn't a power to reset time, just to reset his own life.
I could come back to life.
The events of him dying still happened.
Yeah. And he comes back to life, and... You think they wrote that in to begin with, that was his power, or they just were, like, using that gag so much, they're like, oh, okay, we gotta explain this.
I'm sure they explained it later after it was just a gag. Because that's been done in other series, too. Eustace died at the end of, like, every Courage episode.
Yeah. Well, not everyone. There was, like, some where he just kind of... He survived.
Many Courage episodes.
Yeah. There's the one where he's, like... He, like, stole a stone slab or whatever. And
the slab!
Yeah. He's, like... He's like, ah, he survived all three plagues. He got nothing else. And then the guy just kills him.
Yeah.
He's like, whoa, oh, well, okay, I'm just gonna have you eaten by locusts.
That episode legitimately frightened me as a child. That was some spooky shit.
Yeah, it was, well, the guy, the ghost dude, was very weird because they animated him differently than they did everybody else. Which I really like as a technique to just get over. Like, oh, this guy looks really creepy.
Yeah.
Like, they should have did that with the Titans. They should have had them be 3D.
Oh, yeah.
That would have made them a lot more scary. Attack on Titan.
My company's got this new product, Nitro Honey Syrup.
What?
It seemed like a good idea at the time. Used properly, can even raise the dead.
I don't believe you. Wait.
But if it mixes with certain things, it's explosive.
Oh, do you have to give that to the ghost to resurrect him?
Yeah, sure, that's what happens.
Oh, God.
Someone's stolen your briefcase, and someone has also stolen a pair of gold earrings and shell...
What were there rat dudes in the Mario universe? What game was that from?
I don't remember.
Are those from, like, Super Mario World?
Maybe Super Mario Land? They'd have to have appeared in something before.
Oh, wait, he thinks he's Luigi. Okay.
Find the thief.
We're proving our brother's rep right now.
With one person.
Yeah.
Just trying to remember what order we're supposed to do these things in.
Have you seen my shell earrings? No. Should I have... reminds me of anything.
I know who did it, but I don't know if there's like some flags we have to trigger first or something.
I'll check first, and then if not, if he doesn't like say,
Well, look.
A vital paper.
Now we gotta take this all the way to the back of the train.
We developed a honey syrup so potent it can resurrect the dead.
Wait, and you'll never see it in a Paper Mario game.
Nitrous is like nitroglycerin, that's like green, right?
I mean, that's what it's commonly portrayed as.
Are they trying to make a Reanimator joke here? Because in Reanimator was green as well.
Wait, is that like a movie?
Yeah, Reanimator. Herbert West. It was like based off of a Lovecraft story. It was this crazy scientist called Herbert West who created a serum that could resurrect the dead.
Yeah.
And he like used it on multiple people. And the problem was is that when they came back to life, they didn't come back to life like fully. Like their heart wasn't beating and stuff, but...
Yeah.
But, it worked. And, he, like, ends up decapitating this one dude, and then injecting him with the serum, and he's, like, says to him, like, how are you feeling right now? Just like, well, dude, you're such a dick. You kill this guy, decapitate him, and then resurrect him?
Like, he asked the head that, or the
yeah,
body?
Yeah, the head.
Okay.
But you know what's fucked up?
It can't
speak. The body moved on its own.
Oh.
That made no sense, but also fit in with that movie's logic.
So is that what inspired Dr. Reanimator with Move Your Dead Bones?
Yeah, probably. So yeah, that's what I'm thinking of. Is that guy supposed to be Herbert West? Maybe.
Who, the mouse?
Yeah.
Nobody's here.
It's a famous movie. I mean, there was a scene in which the decapitated body was moving this head, and he was about to like give cunnilingus to this chick who didn't want it, but
yeah,
it didn't happen. It was a threat of it. Then Herbert West came and is like, "You're undead and you're still wanting to fuck chicks? Jeez, dude." He's like trying to shame this guy that he killed.
Oh, right, it's not, he's not in his room, he's in a different room.
If I did this all the time while on one of the trains, like one of the Cascade or Amtrak trains,
just running
I'd probably get run out on a rail.
Running around trying to solve mysteries?
Yeah.
There's someone in your room, bro.
So he's trying to frame us of stealing the nitro honey syrup.
Look, Mario, it's not like I'm your ally or anything, but I'm just telling you because it's annoying me. There's a guy in your room right now.
Another document from the briefcase. And I was running around just having me tired. I was getting me tired.
And pop. Hello.
Hi.
Where'd you come from?
You got him.
You won't be catching me that easily.
That usually takes a while, right?
Nah, he just follows the same jumping pattern from place to place. I knew you weren't the real Ziptoad. Well, gang, time for us to unmask our little friend.
Who is it?
Ruh-roh, Raggy.
Old man Hitler.
Like, how do you think the nitro honey syrup tastes, Scoob?
Can't talk, my eyes are going out of my head. Oh, we're here.
We're at Riverdale Station. I mean, Riverside Station.
Riverdale!
This is gonna be as dark
weird,
and dramatic.
It's as if this place is permanently stuck in the 50s.
It's creepy.
All these people are wearing... everybody here is either a hot cheerleader or a jock.
It's like, what was that movie you told me about, Pleasantville?
Yeah. That's the one where it's like everything's stuck in like the 50s. And
Dupless!
Wait, Dupless turned into like a girl and just started robbing everyone?
A guy. Yes.
Oh, guy? That was a guy?
Yeah.
It's pretty hot for a guy.
Yeah. Well, he's an actor, you see. He's got sparkles.
Ah. Fishy sparkles.
And now we have a very brief dungeon section because they decided to throw us a bone and actually have a part that had, like, traditional exploration and enemies and shit.
That's good. I guess it's the breather before the moon raid.
Yeah.
I guess they didn't want people to get burned out between... the island adventure and the moon raid.
Someone's raised the bridge. Ah, you can jump it. That's how trains work, right?
Give Mario a cape. He can go get to the other side.
Can you do it, Mario? That would be super.
Can you do it? I would, but I don't wanna.
Fine. I'll do everything once again.
At least he gets the credit for it.
Yeah. No, Luigi does.
Oh yeah, that's right. He's not Mario, he's Luigi in this one.
No music. Good design choice.
That's creaky.
Get the thing.
Win.
Wacky! Hello, incredibly jacked.
I'm not, but he is.
Still no music.
Are we
just
talking about
wins.
Scott Steiner jacked or just Hulk Hogan jacked?
Is Scott Steiner really, really jacked?
Yeah, he was for a while. Cause you know he did steroids.
Yeah.
Unapologetically did steroids.
What do you got, Rough Puff?
Rough Riders.
7-4-0.
You can take them.
And they can charge with electricity.
Oh, you needed the hammer after all. No, you didn't.
We'll level up pretty soon.
Yeah, you just need to kill more people. Oh.
I'm gonna kill you!
So, if you were to use the hammer outside of combat, would Jumpman not apply?
Presumably not. You would just get the normal, you'd get the pre-strike, but you couldn't use it from the menu.
Food for thought, I guess, for me. Alright, how's this gonna work?
Very well.
10. So, 14 and 10.
Equip all of the power-up badges. You're a powerhouse.
Yeah. You swing a hammer and there's just a hole where the barn used to be.
That one badge guide that I looked up with the guy that came up with all the different variations. Danger Mario wasn't until the very bottom and it came with a preface that he was like saying, I only included this because people would bitch if I didn't. If you play Danger Mario, fuck you.
Why?
Or something along those lines.
Why? Because it's not creative enough?
It's too easy. It takes all the fun away.
Guys are really salty for no reason. It's not like competitive magic net decking or anything.
Yeah.
It's just a single player game. Now, there's a guy complaining about oh, I included Splinter Twin just because people would bitch if I didn't, then that makes more sense, but...
Yeah?
Come on, man.
Alright, got the key. Man, Riverdale sucks.
Yeah, well, there's only like two women and one guy's got them both, I guess.
Did you see that, did you see the Robot Chicken Archie parody with Final Destination?
You told me about it, but I didn't see it, no. How'd that go?
I mean, it was a Final Destination parody.
I guess, yeah.
About sums it up. Oh, that actually wasn't enough. I got cocky.
Yeah, you did.
Let me
guess.
That's
what you get for not following through.
Yep, 840. Get me! Nope!
Nope, he just missed. Because
what a wild miss. I hope this video doesn't desync like the last one. Because that adds a lot of time before it goes on online.
Yeah. Can't do it immediately. Alright. Mess with your badges. You can add stuff now.
Yeah. Double pain.
Mega rush. Oh, what's that one do again?
That one is for in peril.
Well, fuck that.
Yeah, we don't need that. We need to chill out. Flower saver's good whenever we manage to get that.
Yeah. But we don't have it. Oh! Huh. We can unequip one more. Make that work. Okay, no happy heart. Well, we're not getting hit it often enough, so. Okay, there you go.
Just to see.
He reaches for his hammer. He realizes he doesn't have it on him. And he flails his hands a little bit and then shrugs.
Yeah.
Bella is not gonna do shit against them.
No.
What? Rally Wink? Oh!
Because why not? This is a stupidly powerful move.
Yeah! Hey, it's Mario. He's ultra badass. Let's give him two turns.
After your main combat phase, get another combat phase.
Sure, we can use that somehow.
Uh-oh.
It's okay, you get succumbed to first strike.
No, but they can still start the battles.
Well, yeah, that's true.
I guess I can take them all out, it doesn't really matter.
Yes.
Oh, he's spawning more.
Sure. Nope.
See, now I don't have to be good at action commands.
Yeah, no, that's what I was saying. Like,
I just need to be lucky.
You just need to have a high enough defense rating.
Yeah, breakdance it, Coop. I should be fighting these guys. They are worth a lot of stuff.
Yeah, you should. I don't know why you're evading them.
I'm lazy. I'm in a hurry.
Laziness got me in Lagoon, man.
Yeah.
So guys having like massively powerful items and then
never get a chance to use them.
Yeah. Sucks for them. Hey guys.
Elbow drop!
Elbow drop forever. Good job. That actually sounds like there's a crowd now.
Yeah.
Good.
I think we're B-list star? Yeah.
Yeah, B-list.
So I think there's still A-list and superstar are the two higher levels.
So main eventer and icon.
I think we took them all out. Hey, we got music.
Yeah, it's better than nothing. So he walks back, he's covered in blood. He's like, what happened? Nothing.
Ooh. Oh, no, never mind. That's useless. And we wait. Gameplay!
Hey, anybody got a way to, like, extend it for 3 minutes?
They're just grabbing
it. Make it so that you need to blow on it 3 times. Alright, done.
Grabbing a fat lady's tits.
Well, that's the first thing we got done today, so, good work. I'll see you tomorrow. Oh, no!
What'll I do?
They're in the air, and they've got spikes. Get fucked.
Well, gee, these would suck if I didn't have spike shield.
Yeah.
Your defense is pitiful.
Oh, hey. He actually landed a hit on you.
Impressive.
I once saw, like, a long time ago, this is a long time ago, there were, like, some guys talking about knights and, like, armor and how power and how broken they were.
Yeah.
And there's this guy who's like, oh, they're like, no, there's this instructor who was, like, talking to these other guys. And they were like, all right, try to use the sword, get through plate armor. He just grabbed it, like, two-handed it, and just tried to stab through, and people were actually impressive managed to get it through. He's like, well done, you managed to inflict a superficial wound. Meanwhile, this guy did 3 blows to you.
Yeah.
Which is what I'm kind of reminded by here. What? Just like, he hits you once, and then... Oh.
Lucky!
What, was that your turn?
It even works on items.
It's like a guy manages to get like a scratch on him. Meanwhile, he's... Oh, you got it!
I'm playing the sans game. They can't get a single hit on me.
Well, they can,
you
but...
You think I'm just gonna stand there and take it?
It's sans with 5 hit points.
Oh, we lost the music again. RIP.
Yeah, well...
God damn it, you...
The speakers don't work indoors.
Uh-oh.
I love mazes. Do you love mazes?
Love them. He caught me.
Your number was up. Yeah, you take out that guy first.
I take out all of them at once.
Oh, this
unless I fuck up.
Yeah, this is a lot of risk for a whole lot of nothing.
Nah, it's great. I got him.
Oh, perfect. Mario, we gotta talk. You gotta stop abusing the powers we gave you to take out random enemies. God powers aren't a toy. A Drytrum.
It deals 6 of damage. You want me to waste that on a boss?
Well, okay, Drytrum's actually useful here.
Yeah. It's worth one whole hit point.
Yeah, sometimes it's all you need.
Over to kill.
Eat dried shroom. I'm good. He's so sick that he can only stand the dried stuff.
Come get me. Come on. I won't bite. No. They're just making out. Okay.
And you got him.
The secret is to jump on their fragile central bodies.
Yeah, get the gooey center. These guys just... This is kind of unfair, actually.
Yeah? This high-risk style?
Thunderstrike twice? Would that work?
I could, but I'll save one of them.
Alright. Oh yeah, that'll work.
Get him, Goombella! Well, that's just not fair.
Level up again. What do you know?
Yeah, these guys are worth a surprising amount.
Yeah. Who knew random shack in the middle of the desert would have, like, some really good enemies?
It's like they expected us to struggle against these guys or something.
What, you thought this would be like a challenge?
You thought we'd be using a normal build.
You thought.
But you're not messing with your ordinary Mario anymore.
No, I have become Danger Mario.
Is that going to be the title of this one? Fuck.
Danger Mario sounds like a secret agent or something. Like,
Danger Mario, danger. Like, no, like, no!
Like when you had Chase Bannon from,
Johnny Quest.
That would actually really work.
Yeah.
Yeah, Johnny Quest, you got Chase Bannon, and then you had, that Saturday Night, well, not, either Saturday Night Live or Mad TV parody, or some kind of parody of Johnny Quest called Something Danger.
Oh, yeah?
And it was the one where it was like...
Fuck it. I don't think there was anything over there.
God, I have vague memories of this one. It was like... fuck, what did it involve?
You're not thinking of the Venture Brothers.
No, I'm not.
Okay.
No, this isn't Venture Brothers. This is way before the Venture Brothers. I forget. I'll have to look it up later. Flyer Saver, pretty useful.
Yeah.
If you had another one, that'd be even better.
Just put on both of these, cancel each other out for no reason.
You wish. But you still have enough defense that it does that it shouldn't matter, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ah, fuck it. I'll put Happy Heart back on.
Because you need it now. Shoot it out. Wait, really?
You're the guard? Well, I don't even need to waste flower points on you.
I feel like there's been some kind of mistake. Wow, you just phoned it in.
I've been here for 50 years guarding the Holy Grail.
Punches him in the face and takes it. I've been here for a long time. Punch. Well, that was easy.
Is that what happened in the Last Crusade?
No, the Last Crusade, the guy was older. Because he kept using the Grail to, like, keep himself, like, alive.
Yeah.
He was, like, around since the Crusades. And he was still alive in, like, 1960-something?
Yeah.
Is when it takes place.
Alright, let's see how much this does. Three, four. Oh, it gets smaller with each hit.
Yeah. Like power bounce.
Well,
you thought you could get three hits, three damage every hit.
Kinda.
Yeah, they thought of that, buddy.
So it was like, it was five hits, right?
Yeah, or six.
So it did eight damage. Eh. Well, now this is just tedious.
You're not worth the effort. I'll give you one chance. Kill yourself. Oh, wait, you're dead.
I'll give you no chances.
I'll give you one chance. You kill yourselves right here, right now. Because if you don't, I guarantee you, you're... Wait.
What a difficult puzzle.
3, 6, 9, 10, 30, 40. Oh! No math, just hit him.
Yep. No, you'd think there would be some, like, complex order you had to solve or something.
It's like when guys are doing, like, ultra-complicated wrestling moves to each other, and then one guy just decides, wait a minute, and just punches you, and you don't expect it.
Yeah.
Despite it being really simple.
Oh no, how will I get back up again?
Oh no. You have red shoes. You have Sonic's shoes.
Yay.
I'm totally not a girl.
Yeah.
My name is Toadette.
Asexual.
Asexual. What? Gender is just a social construct. Especially considering we have none.
Yeah. It'll let you reach new heights. No, Kapora Gibor, I've got it. Fucking trick answer, have you highlight the repeat one.
You need it. You need to know.
Knowing is half the battle.
What the fuck are those, like, rolled up, like, paper? Is this like, maps?
I guess, or, like, they're probably rail maps.
This is where, this is where the rail goes. Welcome to Riverdale, where all we got is one train station.
It's one train town.
It's a train station and a diner, and the diner is run by two chicks and a guy.
What is, who's the diner run by?
Archie and Betty and Veronica, duh.
Oh, I thought you were referring to whoever actually ran the diner Riverdale.
I don't know who ran the diner Riverdale. Probably the same guy who ran the diner in Pleasantville.
I know... Okay, the characters of Archie I know. There's Archie, Betty, Veronica, Jughead,
yeah,
Moose,
the
and the big dumb jock guy.
Yeah.
And there's like a teacher, like Ms. Grendel or something. Just some old bag.
Oh. Is that like that one teacher in Jackie Chan Adventures, the one who's like, hey, you misbehave, so I'm gonna punish everyone because of it.
Yeah, I think she was a
because
kind of
a I'm a bitch.
I think she was a bit of a bitch. Would of a bitch.
Bitch isn't just referring to a single person, it's just referring to a state of mind.
That was a thing on that was a big deal on live TV at one point when it was still, everything was live and it wasn't recorded. Someone had a line that called for someone to, like someone's mother-in-law, oh yeah, she can be a bit of a witch.
A bit of a bitch.
Yeah, that's what it came out as. And everyone was a little stunned. These weirdos?
What the hell are they?
Nope. Oh, I have to clear them. I can't just push through.
The Dynasty Warriors part of this game.
Doesn't feel like they're getting any thinner.
Oh yeah, they multiply, I guess.
No, you just have to get rid of enough of them for them to fuck off.
They retreated.
See, these parts are too colorful for the rest of the station.
Yeah, they improved those. They gotta get folding technology.
It's like they wanted...
And it clashes with the design of the train station back when they had regular stairs.
They wanted to add some color to it, but they just added it in the wrong way.
Yeah.
They got some Shy Guys toy box parts for this desert outpost.
Hey, what's cheapest? That? Well, the color doesn't match. Fuck it, it's cheap.
It's on clearance sale.
Also, it's cool. It folds out. Don't you want that? I don't know. It kind of clashes with our old 40s train station vibe we got going.
I don't know if I want to trust stairs made of paper.
You don't know what you're talking about. I just put an order for 50 of them. See you tomorrow.
This station looks like it should be out of Andy Griffith.
So 50s. Man, things from the 50s, it just kind of freaked me out. Like, that old era.
Blame Fallout.
Yeah. And I don't know why. I think it's because it's like all those people that were, like, young at the time are now, like, old and or dead.
Everything was so artificial. Nuclear.
Yeah, just...
All right, let's get the fuck out of here.
That, I guess Pleasantville was like, fucked with me.
Yeah.
Oh, you just live here, guy?
Yep.
I feel sorry.
Oh, wait, you forgot me.
He doesn't seem too concerned about it.
He's trapped in Riverdale.
Attention, all passengers. Are we getting off the Amtrak soon? Day three.
such a total.
I've
cool
never been on
morning.
a multi-day train ride. That would have to be cross country, right? Because it's 3 hours from Seattle to Vancouver.
Yeah.
Like south, like Vancouver, U.S. So I'm guessing
it'd have to be cross country or up to Canada or something.
Canada, from California to Canada. Get your passports ready.
From Mexico to Canada.
You gotta take a train ride up to Canada someday.
Do you think there's a? Do you think there is one train that goes all the way from Mexico to Canada?
I'll have to look it up. That sounds like something that would exist, though.
I mean, the closest hot spot for us to go to in Canada would be Vancouver, and that's an island, so I don't think we can take a train there.
Is it an island?
Vancouver.
No, Vancouver, British Columbia is a... I know the British Columbia is like a section of Canada. What?
I thought it was an island, Vancouver, BC.
Oh, what no!
Are these things?
The tribbles have come.
They've stowed away.
I think you're wrong about that, but we got bigger things to worry about right now. Namely, taking care of these things.
Alright, let's go clear our tribble problem. Back with the X-Knots music. Apparently there are multiple colors of these things in the game files.
Oh, really?
So at some point they were probably intended to be a, like, individual fightable enemy.
But then they were like, well, how's it gonna work? It's good, I don't know. Alright, well, we won't use them. We'll just have them be, like, train fodder and that's it.
Woo!
You wonder what?
Smart. I wonder if they were still intending for a big swarm of them to be the final boss of this chapter, or if they had something else in mind.
I don't know. Hey, we saved one.
By smashing her with a hammer. Like gentlemen.
Yeah. Let's fight like gentlemen. God, they do seem to multiply. They retreated again.
Foods. Are the foods safe?
We saved the foods?
All of the foods. And we still have the passengers. Oh no.
Oh no, we'll have to resort to cannibalism.
Oh, that's not the one.
I guess. Hey. Reverse shimmy. Like a boss.
Alright, up and away! No, fuck off.
They don't look that intimidating, they just look like things.
Nope, outrunning! You can see the wave chasing you too, the wave that is supposed to be in front of you.
Oh, gosh.
Smorg!
Not as iconic as the Mjorg.
Snarf!
Man, it's like the 100 wonder, the wonderful 101 over here.
But why does it have to be a giant spider?
I guess it did come full circle.
What is that gross thing? Spider. Oh, look, it's got the passengers. Only one thing to do. We beat the fuck out of it.
We must slay it.
But won't that hurt the passengers? Fuck them!
You aim for the nice, toasty center.
It's for the greater good.
Their sacrifices won't be forgotten.
So all of the four Mario, quote-unquote, brothers are voiced by Charles Martinet.
Oh,
Mario,
really?
Luigi, Wario, and Waluigi. So do you think they can all do really good impressions of one another, just inherently?
We got Mario doing prank calls to Luigi as Wario.
Yeah.
It's the s'more. Oh, that's what they're called.
My brothers are after my money. No. You should give him $5.
Five
Wait, what are these dollars that you speak of?
You should give him a 500 coins. He told me he could really use it right now.
There we go, that makes sense. Oh, what does spring jump do?
It's just a really big hit.
You want to use it, go ahead.
I'm going to clear out the tentacles.
8.
You have to clear out the tentacles before you can damage the main body.
Fair enough. Alright, lay it the smackdown. Wait.
I'm going to tank a little bit. No, wrong one. Rally wink.
2.
Now, I actually probably should have put power bounce on before this one. Oh, well.
Yeah. Oh, well, I guess you'll have to spring stomp.
Oh, I missed it.
Oh, man.
It's hard to time.
Go.
Oh.
Man, dude. Miss. Oh.
Ow.
Goombella in the front, party in the back.
Oh no, whatever will I do?
Oh, I guess I'll, No rally wink, huh?
Yeah, I guess I could've.
Okay, so if you miss with the spring jump, you're gonna be dealing like 11. But if you hit with the regular attack, you'll be dealing 14, so. Or rather, 16. There you go.
Wow.
20. That'd be more than you would have gotten with Power Bounce, I feel. So, that's actually a better move.
I don't know. Power Bounce, I'd start with like 7, then 6, then 5. So, if I hit 3 or 4 of them, I'm already ahead. But, why is the music still going?
You thought it was over?
Isn't it?
It is. I don't like the way that they just decide, hey, the boss battle music's still gonna go.
Yeah, I mean, it fit with the... They didn't do it with the dupless thing, that was to trick you, but that was actually the end of it, so it probably should have ended there.
Yeah.
Even though, I guess, we don't have the crystal star yet. We still haven't arrived at the place.
This chapter sucks.
Yeah, it kinda does.
Like, this chapter is just like, oh, we're phoning it in.
At least we got a sexy mouse that we're banging now.
Oh! The Muzak has become reality.
Oh, this was the same track as on the train.
God damn it. It's literally the same track.
It's just not playing through a shitty speaker. It's actual music now.
Yeah. So, welcome to Roppongi, I guess.
And now we'll unlock the pipe that will take us back to and fro Rogueport in like 2 seconds.
That's why Mario came. He needed to establish. He needed to build a Stargate here.
Mario's the plumber ambassador.
I am the ambassador from Mushroom Kingdom. I'm here to build a pipe system.
He builds the pipes, and they're just vastly more efficient methods of travel.
The train goes out of style.
Alright, you got these guys here.
The train company goes extinct.
I'm not gonna look around the town. I'm gonna do that next video.
Yeah, I feel like we should get the star.
Oh, look, penguins live here.
Of course.
My favorite race!
Penguins are just...
It's okay, they're a fictional race. I'm allowed to be racist against Mario penguins.
Mario
penguins. Fuck Mario penguins.
Yeah, and fuck elves, too.
Gone traveling.
The manager of the sanctum is
this
gone.
This is super weak!
Weak or weird?
Weak is what she said.
Okay, Jade. You see, I am actually the museum curator.
Jade was also kind of insufferable with the 90s speak.
Yeah, 90s speak in 2003. That'll go over.
Alright, well, I guess let's go inside and raid the church. Sorry, place of worship.
Worship
place.
Oh,
no!
No, you should have had fucking Vivian out.
I don't know if the partner says anything, but yeah, I should.
Don't leave without me. So they fade out, and he just jumps out the window.
We're too late.
Just imagine, like, you get, like, a team of just, like, 3 Arrancar, then 1 Arrancar, like, dies or is replaced, and he just replaces him with, like, a Saiyan or something.
Yeah.
And then they just do the fucking go through the port, like...
The portal,
the,
yeah.
The gash thing, and
I
then
I forget
you,
what it's called.
Yeah, and then the Saiyan just...
Wait, flies, you guys, I can't do that!
And he just flies away.
Yeah.
Or... Or, like...
God
or,
damn it, Okiora.
No, this is even better. It's the same thing, except they got, like, a thug with no powers. He just gets in his car and drives off.
I'm not sure about this part-time work you've hired, Aizen. Oh, shut up, it's all part of my grand machination.
No, he's cool. Yeah, Botan repped him personally. Oh, is that the fake crystal star?
I want to see, like, a gathering of the various afterlifes. You know, like a political summit, like the United Nations, but you have, like, a Yamamoto there, you have Koenma there, you have King Yama.
Okay, so, so I only watched one episode of this, but there was, like, a Tomb Raider anime that was going around. It was animated the same style as, like, Animatrix, where each individual, like, artist did their own separate episode.
And oh, yeah.
The first episode was done by the Aeon Flux guy.
Yeah.
Him. I forget what his name is, but it was done by him. And it was basically all the deities going around and like, hanging out together. And it's like, oh, what? They believe there's one true god? And all the gods laugh.
Yeah.
It was like Laura just trying to find, like, an artifact that would allow people to commune with whatever god they wanted or something.
Yeah.
It was very interesting. I only watched it once, but it really stuck with me.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was basically that. You got, like, the Abrahamic god. You had a bunch of Indian gods. You had Thor, obviously, and, like, Odin.
Obviously. And, the god, not the...
Yeah.
Not the, the character from Lagoon.
I think I saw a Shinto demon at one point.
Yeah?
But yeah, it was just all of them.
Whoa, this is meta shit, bro.
This is trippy. So... Wait, how does he have access to this tech? It's weird. Not a boo, it's a dark boo.
They're creepy.
Don't multi-bounce, it won't work.
Yeah, I'm gonna take out the one with the item. Oh, it would've worked. Oh. Oh, right, we got the boots.
Oh yeah, it increases damage. Sorry.
Good move. A plus turn you spent there.
I thought he healed you, like give you a sporting chance.
Just finish me.
It's like you're cornered by a predator and he throws you a flintlock pistol. So it's fair.
Except we had him grossly outmatched and he gave us something.
Yeah, he's like, ugh.
So it's more like the prey throwing a predator flintlock pistol. Make it quick.
Just shoot me with this. That way when they identify my body, you can still hunt or whatever.
I don't think these guys are worth as much as the other ones were.
It's still experience.
Yeah.
Plus, I want to see some combat. We've done a poor amount of combat this
video. We're
gonna
go some ghost hunting.
Ghost hunters.
Hey, I am Luigi.
We Luigi now.
Mario's quest to become Luigi.
I'll kill my brother and I'll take his place. No one will ever know. Hey, Luigi, you seem to have shrunken and gotten a bit fatter. No, I'm just still same old pathetic Luigi.
Let's-a-go. Mario.
Let's-a-go, Mario.
Mario.
He just quick changes from Luigi to Mario whenever he needs to?
Yeah. He's got one hat hidden under the other hat.
During the day, in order to disguise his identity, Mario turns into Luigi. Mild-mannered plumber.
Mild-mannered entrepreneur. Luigi Wayne.
Luigi Wayne.
But undercover of nice.
Mario.
Crime fighter supreme, Mario. Adventurer extraordinaire.
Nobody's been able to figure out his identity. It's weird.
No one's ever seen Mario and Luigi in the same place at the same time.
this, Does that mean his evil counterpart is Wario, but during the day he's Waluigi?
Now that's a curse. That's like some magic if his body's changing that much.
Yeah.
He fell in the spring of drowned fat guy. Or the spring of drowned genie, maybe.
That's why he has those shoes.
Yeah. Waluigi's a genie. He's also a waterbender, did you know that?
Oh, was he?
He's a waterbender.
God damn it, I walked right into that.
We got like...
You just getting everything.
We got three or four levels this match. This.
Oh, all the boos are watching. They're cheering you on. That's good.
Yeah, the light boos are cheering us as we clear out the dark boos.
They're evil.
They're discredited.
They're black magic. The boos are white magic.
Yeah.
They're good magic, as opposed to this is evil magic.
I can't believe we got those two. That Spunia and Spania had the two pretty lucky badges. That was a crazy coincidence.
That was a boon.
Two at once.
Yeah. I mean, those are good badges.
Now it is right there, but let's dawdle.
I mean, they already have what they thought is the crystal star. It's not like it's not like they'll figure it out and double back immediately.
Unless they do. And Mara's just fucking off in the rafters.
They all go in, they're like, oh, that's the real crystal star, and then Mario jumps down from the rafters like he's fucking Sting.
I am in the night!
Oh, it's Mario! They say he's the bodyguard of Luigi.
They say they're brothers.
But they've never been in the same room twice.
Look, it's Peter Parker, Spider-Man's best friend.
/ personal photographer. You missed. I guess
nah, I was checking if there was anything down here. This is better music than this is better music than anything on that fucking train.
Yeah. So... to Iron Man is like Tony Stark's night job or whatever. He's a superhero.
Except everyone knows it in his case.
Well, that wasn't always true. Because in the Marvel Comics universe, they're like, fuck it. Yeah, he's just going to be out and out Iron Man. Oh,
It's Ango.
All right, nobody will recognize me. I'm back in my secret identity.
As Batman changed back into Bruce Wayne. Ah, fuck it, power bounce. Is this part of Partially Sanctum 2? Exactly how does all of this work? Don't think about it too hard.
It's the Dark Realm. They hid the star in a gash in time.
Yeah, it's the Dark World.
That's it? Wow.
That's it.
No boss. Huh?
And I can use Showstopper.
Oh, wait, we already had the boss.
Which is either... I think that's the one that insta-kills if it's performed perfectly. I mean, insta-kills weaker enemies.
But yeah, basically, Iron Man was like the bodyguard / mascot of Tony Stark's Industries.
Yeah.
So that was that. Well, that was easy.
Where could the last crystal star be?
The moon.
And where is Peach being held?
The moon. Look up.
Hoping this crystal star might yield answers, Mario and friends return to Pennington. And let's see if we go back to the penguin or to a Bowser thing.
If we go back to the penguin, then we're not done yet. We're not done yet. It ain't over till Peach shows up. Till the slim lady says hi.
I think it'll go straight to Bowser after we talk to the penguin.
Oh,
yeah,
sure.
Let's just hang out in here. Let's make this our Luigi Wayne hideout until the next stream.
Yeah, the fucking the Mario cave.
The star worship, cave. The place of worship.
Yeah.
2.5 hours. Could have been worse.
Yeah.
We fit a lot of outside stuff in before the actual chapter.
It was one of the worst. I mean, it was one of the most boring chapters.
Hit the chapter start thing, like board the train and it shows the title, until an hour 15 minutes.
Well, yeah.
So the actual chapter took an hour and 15 minutes.
I feel good.
Yeah.
Do you feel good?
Yeah, we accomplished a lot. We filled out our party. Our party's done, and we've become Luigi.
Yep. Just wait till the next episode where we become Wario.
And then Waluigi.
Take care, everyone.